Tonight, the NewsHour bookshelf. Jeffrey Brown sits down with Pulitzer Prize-winning author Michael Chabon about his new book, Moonglow, and the blending of fact and fiction in literary art.
Moonglow, a classic tune performed by Benny Goodman. Background music in the Berkeley, California writing studio of Michael Chabon, where he often works deep into the night. Moonglow is also the title of Chabon's new book, a novel that's presented as a kind of memoir, blurring the lines between truth and fiction.
You're telling a lie when you're writing a novel. A novel is a lie.
Right.
It's the only good kind of lie. It's the lie that you're telling to someone with their permission, and not only with their permission, but at their invitation. So the reader comes to the novel and says, lie to me.
Yeah.
I want to hear it. Like,
and
tell
you,
me a story.
And you, the author, say, let me tell you a good lie.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
That's part of what's so beautiful about that particular relationship, is that it's a kind of voluntary submission to deception, just like with magic.
In this case, the magic started with an actual ad he found from a 1958 Esquire magazine for something called Chabon Scientific Company that sold models of missiles that you can fly.
My name, Chabon, if that's your last name, you're related to me somehow.
Yeah.
There aren't very many Chabons in the world.
But this Chabon had never heard of that company. No one had. So he invented its story as part of Moonglow.
I defy anyone using Google to contradict anything I say about the history of Chabon Scientific Company in my book.
Because there ain't no history.
Not yet. I mean, they may come forward.
There is now.
The real, the descendants of the founding Chabon of that company may emerge and to tell their version of the story. But until that happens, Google can't help you. You're at my mercy.
Then there was this man, Chabon's real grandfather, who on his deathbed under the influence of pain-killing drugs began telling his then 26-year-old grandson unknown stories from his life. This, too, became fodder for the novel.
There was all this stuff I was hearing that was clearly still there, mm-hmm. That was in his mind, in his memory, in his experience, in his life, that I'd never heard before. And it just was all kind of coming out. And I thought, like, you think you know somebody, you think you've heard their stories,
right.
And then to suddenly, at the very end, get this glimpse of an entire other life that I had never heard of before. Not that it was a life of dark secrets or anything like that, but just there was so much more.
Then that opens the floodgates for you, and you, being a novelist, get to play, right?
That's what I do with every book.
Right.
I mean, that procedure of taking bits and pieces of and elements of lived experience, of stories I've heard, anecdotes and research or whatever it might be, gets all swirled together with the invention. The reader wants to hear the lie that sounds true. And that ultimately, I think, in the case of fiction, in the case of a novel, that delivers a truth.
To see Chabon's studio is to peek into the brain that produces that invention. Action figures, vintage science fiction and fantasy novels, vinyl records. Much of it connected to things he's written, from the Pulitzer Prize-winning Adventures of Cavalier and Clay to now the mashup of Moonglow, which explores war, family, and technology in mid-century America and mixes historical figures with the fictional.
War, rocketry, space travel, even, you and I have talked about this before, and you're writing some of the genre bending, it's mm-hmm. a sort of memoir, but it gets mm-hmm. sort of into almost fantasy.
Love among people in their golden years.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes, a lot of things going mm-hmm. on there. But that allows you the freedom. Once you have that freedom, you're off, right?
Right, I mean, then that's what it's all about. The facts are so dull.
And they're so dull. So,
I mean, we turn to fiction, we turn to the novel, because fiction persuades us,
mm-hmm.
I mean, all art persuades us
mm-hmm.
that there's a pattern
yeah.
to life, that there's meaning to life, that if you look at life the right way, you can see sense in it, you can find meaning in it. It might not be true, maybe that's an illusion, maybe that's like the greatest illusion
yeah.
of the magic act of literature, but I don't care. That's what's good about it. That's what we turn to it for.
The novel is Moonglow. Michael Chabon, thank you for letting us visit.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you, Jeff. Thank you.